Hello and welcome to Chess with Simon. I'm Simon, this is Chewy. Chewy's come to see if we're going to go for a walk, but the bad news is, Mr. Dog, that it's raining outside, or it's probably stopped physically raining, but it's still wet. We might go after this video, actually. We might well go. But before that, we are going to look at a wonderful game of chess from the OCA Cowley Blitz tournament. So Phil Haywood is black, Drecco is white. Drecco plays for Cowley Chess Club. Drecco, if you'd like to write more about yourself in the comments, please feel free, even if you see this video. If you'd like to keep your identity secret, then that is absolutely fine. Phil came second in this wonderful tournament, so rich congratulations to Phil. Well done for that. You may have wanted to come first. We all want to come first, buddy. I get that. But you came second, which is splendid. So let's look at what happened. E4, E6, Phil plays the French, a great expert on the French. Pawn D3, so there's a kind of King's Indian attack type setup here, which is often used by the white players who might want to sidestep the main lines of the French. I've got a dog around my face. Pawn D5 from black. You've got to play knight D2 because otherwise, well, if black takes on E4, white takes back, the queen's come off. In fact, there's a line of the Caro-Kann now that Anish Giri is playing where he allows that. So I think he allows, what happens? E4, C6, D3, D5. Don't they all play knight F3 now and allow the end game after takes on E4, takes on E4, takes on D1? Anyway, I think that's right. But the classical way, the standard move is knight D2. C5 from black. And then white going ahead to fianchetto the king's bishop. Actually, the really accurate move order here is knight gf3, just giving black the chance to take on e4, and then white can take back with the d pawn, and possibly develop the bishop on that on the other diagonal, so squares like c4. I saw Anna Rudolph play a game like that, which went very well for her. International master Anna Rudolph. So g3. Knight c6, good move. Fianchetto the bishop, since you've declared your intention. You want to get down, Mr.? Okay, just get down gently because you're on my... Wah! Okay, there you go. Full of energy. Bishop g2. Black's fianchettoing. So this is a sort of database move. I mean, there is knight f6 as well, but this is the database move. And it's quite a good way to defend the king's side, just to kind of fianchetto as well. Knight f3 from white, complete the fianchetto from black, castle. Then knight e7. Now, knight could come to f6, but it's less popular. The point about knight f6 is that white can play e5 with tempo. So black sidesteps that. I also play the closed Sicilian this way with a knight on e7 when I'm playing the black side of the closed Sicilian, which can produce very similar structures, perhaps with a knight on c3 rather than on d2. White puts the bishop, the rook on the open file. Black, queen c7, sensible move, and connecting the rooks. And then white goes ahead and plays h4. Now, this isn't in the database, or not in the live chess database. We've seen a lot of this, though, haven't we? These kind of rooks pawn moves in this tournament, just potentially heading for a kingside attack. Black h6, which gives black options. You know, after an h5, then black can think about playing g5, for instance, and it's defended by the pawn. So white says, right, I'm going to play the rook's pawn on one side, I'll play on the other side. This inhibits black's queenside expansion. So, for instance, after a move like a6, it stops black playing. Well, it does stop black playing b5, actually, because then the a-pawn's pinned. So a6, you can't play b5, because then white's taking on b5, and the a-pawn can't take, because the rook will drop. So black plays a more restrained move, b6. And then white starts to redeploy the knight. This is thematic in the King's Indian attack, and also in the Royal Pairs, the Spanish game. The knight manoeuvring through f1, perhaps to e3, perhaps to h2. Black castles, white knight moves to h2, and then the bishop fianchetto is on the long diagonal. We'll see this actually comes in very handy for black, and it's essentially just opposing that the white light square bishop, which then moves itself. I've seen Phil play this, so when Phil was playing white, he's played this against me, actually, and it caused me a lot of problems, although in the end I was lucky enough to deal with it, but it caused me a lot of problems. It's so it'd be funny for Phil to see this, because this is a move he sometimes plays. He played it against me after a kind of c4, a sort of Retty type setup, really. I'd played moves like e6 and d5. I'd played similar moves, actually, although I hadn't fianchettoed on the king's side. My rook comes opposite the queen. Black's rook, I've turned into Phil. Black's rook comes opposite the queen, and that creates threats, and straight away the d-pawn is pinned. So white puts the bishop in the way. I wouldn't have handled it that way myself. I think the engine wants to play e5. I think that threat needs to be addressed. Maybe queen e2, maybe taking on d5. Anyway, bishop in the way. King here, I think the idea of king h7 is just to in advance protect that h-pawn. And indeed, white plays queen c1 attacking the h-pawn, so black's move, black was clearly reading white's mind. And now Phil's playing this move f5, and as we've seen from the last game, Phil's a Dutch player. He plays the Dutch defence, and so this move will come naturally to him, or certainly come into consideration. And also, in a sense, this is black's got a sort of King's Indian setup. I mean, the queen's not really where you'd expect it in the King's Indian, but it's got a King's Indian type setup against a King's Indian attack, so black has almost out King's Indian'd white. And white's just pushed on and said, right, I'm going to sack that h-pawn and cause some trouble for black. Black accepts. White plays a knight f4, a knight h4, and all of a sudden, the engine just thinks that black's won this. Now, this isn't clear to me, or this doesn't jump out at me, but Phil just follows the engine line, takes on e4, white takes back. And then this knight d4 move turns out to be a real horror show for white, because all of a sudden there's just a lot of weak squares. I mean, the bishop on the long diagonal is a beauty. The knight's very active too, and there's just a lot of weak squares. E2 is weak. F3 can't be defended by a pawn, although it's covered by two minor pieces. There's just a lot of weaknesses, and white moves to eliminate this advanced knight, but black has taken a pawn with the bishop, and again, those weak squares around the king look very sort of sore. White takes the choice to eliminate the black light square bishop, which was causing all the problems. Black takes back, and then, you know, there's a minute left on the clocks, and there's still a lot of pieces on, so we're in bullet chess territory. White tries to create some activity on the queen side by opening a file, but not realizing that knight e2 is a forking king and queen. White plays on, just thinking, well, it's bullet, why not? So then now black's swapping. I'm going to play this quite quickly because that's in the spirit of how it would have been played. Swapping, black's swapping, check here on the open file. Now black's irritating this rook, hoovering up a pawn, pinning the rook against the king. White checks the black king, and whether black just did this to swap down or missed this, I've no idea. Phil, please feel free to tell us in the comments or in any other way. But Phil took, giving up the queen, but actually there's a check here with the rook, so two rooks against a king is absolutely overwhelming, and also there was actually checkmate in two or three moves. And so, in other words, it could be that black just saw all of this. How much has black got? 51 seconds on the clock. I mean, it's completely possible that black saw all of this. So takes here. The white rook's no longer defended, so taking on d1 is going to lead to mate very quickly. Bishop takes queen, check, check, and then actually it's mate next move, because king h3, rook h1. So really powerful game by black, actually. White played an attacking opening, but black was able to get those kind of King's Indian advantages himself, and a really nice positional game where I think you know, the collapse of the center and the weak light squares around white's king caused problems. I hope you've enjoyed this. I'm going to check the weather. I might take Chewy for a walk, and we will both see you soon.